Well, happy Tuesday to you, Shenandoah. It's a snow day at MCA, and however, SBBC is still open for business, and just wanted to touch base with you this week, and I hope you're staying safe out on the roads if you have to be out for work, and Lord willing, this stuff's going to go away here quickly as the temperatures rise today, but I hope you're doing well. I wanted to talk to you just a moment philosophically about the need for meetings. And you'll see why I am saying this as we get into this update this morning. You know, the Bible talks about the church being an assembly. And I've done quite a bit of preaching in the last many months about the need for assembling. I think that obviously there are times in a pandemic when a virtual church has its place. Last spring, we had to go completely virtual, and I understand that was for a season. But obviously, there came a time where the church had to get back together. You know, the same is true for even meetings within the church to help the church move forward. Services, obviously, would be a time of keeping the momentum moving forward and giving the instruction that we all need. I have weekly staff meetings, for instance, and monthly board meetings and quarterly treasurers, trustees meetings. Meetings certainly are important. They do three things. Meetings cast vision, meetings continue momentum, and meetings give a camaraderie with those who are involved. And so I say all of that to lead up to say that tomorrow evening will be our first here in 2021 of what I'm calling a monthly workers meeting, an all workers meeting. And you've heard announcements about it, and I'm looking forward to everybody that does anything here at Shenandoah. Do you teach a Sunday school class? Do you run a bus route? Are you involved in RU on Friday evenings? Do you work in junior church? You do something to serve, to allow the ministry of SBBC to go forward. I'm going to meet with you tomorrow evening at 6:15. That is typically our Sunday school teachers only meeting, but I'm going to include everybody here for the next 5 months. It'll always be the last Wednesday evening of the month. So this coming Wednesday, 6:15, room 102, I hope that you'll be there. And then this Sunday is MCA Sunday, January the 31st, and our 10:45 service will be given to a focus of Martinsburg Christian Academy. And we're about to enter our 50th year. Can you believe that? Thank God for the vision of Pastor Don and Miss Joanne. And what a great, great thing happened 50 years ago. And I've tried to do my best in the last 8 years to not just keep the doors open, but to allow MCA to flourish and blossom and thrive. You know, we even gained enrollment at the beginning of this year, even in the midst of a pandemic. And so we thank God for that. So we're going to be kicking off early registration. Now, let me explain that since this primarily is to our church folks. What that means is February the 1st, okay, which is next Monday, for about 2 weeks, the only folks that can register are Shenandoah folks, meaning you have a tie here to our church. And obviously Shenandoah and MCA are intertwined, and we try to be good to our families first. We give you a discount, for instance, if you are an active member of Shenandoah Bible Baptist Church. So that being said, before we entertain anyone from the outside, we want you to get signed up quickly and first. So you better save your spot. There's already a waiting list. And Brother McRae is very, very excited. He's already been meeting with families, talking about MCA for the next school year. And then let me encourage you to please to get signed up for the Sweetheart Banquet, an evening in Paris, as Brother Harris has so eloquently been telling us. Weren't those videos hilarious? I love Brother Harris. I love his happy spirit about things, especially when you're getting behind a pulpit or behind a video camera, right? But anyhow, please go by the office and purchase your ticket. $20 per person. It'd be a great date night for some of you men to take your wives out right here at Holiday Inn. It's going to be a beautifully decorated banquet facility, a wonderful, wonderful meal, a guest speaker, skits and music, and there's just all kinds of stuff planned. Let me say it this way. Would you invest in your relationship? All right, $20 a person. You're going to spend that if you go out for a nice dinner somewhere else. So take your spouse or your beloved or your engaged fiance. It's for anyone who'd like to come, any adult who would like to come, and it's going to be a beautiful time together. And then as I just close, I just was thinking, you know, we have one more Sunday in January. That's all. And this has been a 5-week January, 5 Sundays, and entering into February, second month here of 2021, we've had a great start. Every Sunday we've had someone either saved, baptized, or added to the church. Well, that's wonderful. God is still adding to His church. And I hope that you'll be a part of the grand reopening. I know we used that phrase back in the spring, but you know, the grand rebuilding, maybe let's call it that, the grand rebuilding of Shenandoah Bible Baptist Church. God still has something for us. I believe it. And I promise you, I'll come every Sunday and every Wednesday ready to preach, ready to teach, ready to invest in the ministry, ready to have a spiritual mindset, and that we're all on the same team and all on the same page in 2021. Hope you have a great, great Tuesday. And I hope everybody will either be in person tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock or online for the Wednesday night Bible study. God bless you. Have a great day.